This time we are gonna try the motorized version of the 42141 McLaren F1 car. So basically, to motorize this set, it took me quite a lot of time, a bit of trial and error, and I'm just gonna explain in short what I did and what are the ups and downs. So first thing I had to do, if we start with the rear, I'm gonna flip the model like this. So as you can see in the rear, I'm using a stronger differential with a combination of the stronger CV joints to drive the rear wheels. And this gives me a higher gear ratio because I was limited by the space. I could only use two BuWizz motors, so I'm using a higher gear ratio than normally, so the model can reach only around 13 kilometers an hour, but that's enough for driving around. Another thing I had to modify was the rear suspension, which was raised by around 0.7 studs. And as you can see, here is where I placed the BuWizz 3.0 motor controller and the two BuWizz motors, which are driving the fake engine, and the fake engine is actually driving the wheels. So the fake engine in this case is actually a functional element. And if you go forward, you can see the BuWizz motors are placed directly behind the driver's seat, and in front of the driver's seat we have the powered up L motor for steering, which is driving the which is steering the front wheels and also of course steering the steering wheel. The front suspension was also changed so that the ground clearance was increased by one stud to cope with the extra weight. As with all our motorized modifications, we try to preserve the looks and the original functionality. So the fake engine works and the steering wheel also rotates along with the wheels. So we're gonna test drive this motorized version of the 42141 a bit, and then I'm probably gonna go to the straight there and see what kind of a top speed we can get. Okay, let's give it a shot. Okay, so let's see, this is just a try. 12.3 kilometers an hour.
What was that sound?
Oh. Since we have a mechanical problem. Aha, this one. We have to replace this axle. Okay. So this was our first outdoor test, and it seems that we have a problem here. It seems like the axle melted, or the whole brick melted. We will see. First I'll just try to replace the broken axle, and then we'll see. Ah. Yeah, it's stuck in there. I just can't put it out. Seems to have melted inside.
Go.
Oh. Huh.
So what, the hole is too small, or it's not circular, or not
both.
Smooth?
Both.
No, all of those.
It doesn't go in.
It would not be possible to get this axle out without breaking it, because the hole is, you know, it's smaller than the axle basically.
I think something came inside.
Doesn't go through.
I'm pretty sure something came inside.
Dust or small stones?
No, yeah. I'm just gonna reuse the part, I'm just gonna flip it around. But yeah.
So when you flip it, you just flip it like this, right?
No.
Why not?
We had to take a break and fix the rear wheel drive, basically because I didn't lubricate the gears and the axles. The main drive axle driving the differential kind of melted into the frame, and I had to replace it. Okay, now let's see what kind of speed we can reach with this model. We already drove the model a bit before and we reached 12.3 kilometers an hour. And now we're gonna go on the straight and see if we can go a bit faster. Okay, let's see how fast that was. 13.1 kilometers an hour. So it makes sense because this model uses around 2.5 lower gearing than the Lamborghini, and the speed is also around 2 times slower. If I had more space, of course I would have fitted more BuWizz motors and more BuWizz bricks, but we were limited by the space and the shape of the model, so it's okay, I guess. It's still a fun model to drive around. So now that we tested the model, I'm gonna go over the pros and the cons. So the first major con is that if we're gonna release the instructions for this model, I highly recommend that you lubricate all the moving parts, because this here is a weak point and it may cause your axles to also melt like ours did. A small issue is again is also the ground clearance. It's really low and the model is basically scratching the floor, the ground all the time, even though I raised the suspension. The original was even lower. Now to the positive sides, everything is working. The fake engine is preserved, the rear wheel drive works, the steering works, the model is quite maneuverable, and the speed is actually not that low as I expected. I expected around 12 kilometers an hour, but we went over 13 kilometers an hour. So yeah, 13.1. So I think that's good. But I would suggest you keep this model for indoor driving only, and to, like I mentioned before, lubricate all the moving components with grease. So yes, I'm quite happy with the model. It was a big challenge to motorize, to fit everything in, and in the end it works. It's not perfect, but I think it's a good model to drive around and have fun with. Given the packaging of the original set and the challenges I had to overcome to motorize the set, I am quite proud that I actually managed to get it running. And if you're also happy about seeing such motorized set, please remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell. Thank you.